Oh, hello. Welcome to everything. Everything, everything, and nothing all at the same time. I am jilltess. I have a few things. I love how I can just talk however I want and however. Do you guys see what a great hair day that this is? That this is? Like, it's like, I don't even know. Like, it might be the best hair day I've ever had. Do you see this? Do you see this? I have one dog outside and one dog inside right now. This is what we do. We let all the blood run back into my brain. I let all of my bodily fluids do their jobs while I'm upside down, and I meditate. And I meditate. And I ask myself so many important questions. So today, I do believe I have a little bit of something that I want to talk about. It is, oh, you know what, Penny, you can go out too. It's fine. Yeah, it's fine. You guys can go outside. Okay, so it is today, what is it? It is the 4th of December, 2021. I don't like 2021. I don't know. I think I prefer to say the entire number in its entirety of the year, even though time is a freaking silly business. Oh yes, I have to do that. Okay, so today, for the past little tiny bit, I have been toying with the notion of making an announcement to change my pronouns to they, them. But at the same time, every time I have this discussion with myself. If you guys think I have schizophrenia or whatever, I don't fucking care, okay? Because here's what I know. I know that when I came to this, when I chose to come to this planet, and my soul made a contract to be here and choose my parents and my family and all of that, and ultimately choose, the gender scientifically that I was assigned, at birth, that, I would also be taking on all of these other, feelings of not being a real girl as to what society, wants me to conform to. First of all, because, like, women, like, here's the thing, like, this is nothing new that I am making up whatsoever. This has nothing to do with attention or anything like that. In fact, I feel like this is me finally, after 41 years, 41 and a half years and 4, 6 days. Honest to fucking God, okay? That this is how I've always felt and identified, and very early on in my, you know, being very growing up with a father that's a minister and a mother who really, I still honestly don't even know what in the world who she has absolutely, here's the thing. I'm her daughter, but she has no idea who I am or what I'm up to or anything. And honestly, she will probably die before I can get her to understand or accept or even listen or even have any clue how, you know, I don't even know. Okay. No, I do know. Okay. And my father, honestly, I mean, if I'm going to be completely honest, the freaking guy invalidates my life experience and who I am and everything that I've gone through. Pretty much, here's the thing. As I'm trying to heal myself and make sense of my entire existence, every time I speak to him, he literally makes me feel worse about myself. And ultimately, I do not understand, first of all, because I do not have children, human children, and because I do not understand this conditional love kind of stuff, or how I feel like it is like when you've put so much of your beliefs and who you are and you've given so much of your personal power away to being a Christian, but then as you honestly freaking just hypocritically run around and truly, like, when I don't know if I can take on any societal label whatsoever because of all the preconceived notions and the whatever behind all of it. And that is why I choose to the label. This is not even a label. This is like a feeling, okay, of a fluidity that I have had to forgive myself of so many things and go so deeply within myself, truly as an inside job. I know that looking outside of myself for any answers, so many people think I should probably go to therapy. That I should go to therapy to heal myself. When here's the thing, like, all I have to do is come to terms with who I am and why I am the way I am. You know, every moment of every day, I am the only one that has to live my life and be in this freaking beautiful, beautiful little vessel I have, this little apparatus of unlimited potential that if I listen to anyone anymore, other than, here's the thing, if people are loving me and encouraging me and that sort of thing and saying, you do you, Jill, you be you, great, that makes me feel great, even though I am the only one that really knows how I feel inside, and it is not up for debate. Okay, like, today I woke up and I felt very, 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 very male. And then as the morning progressed and after I meditated and that sort of thing, I have been trying to be very self-aware within myself of what my masculine energies are and what my female energies are. And then while I was in the shower, I'm singing and I was listening to myself musically. And I suddenly had this gigantic wave of femininity and appreciation for absolutely how beautiful I am. Now, I appreciate this body that I'm in, but you know what? This is something I don't even know. I'm going to fucking say it. I cannot stand anymore being objectified by men and their fucking stupid penises that pretty much honestly, if you were circumcised as a baby boy, you really don't even realize what was taken from you before you fucking had any choice of knowing of your body what happened. And I do not even think the surface has been scratched of what kind of damage that does to boys that become men and have to live in this society with vaginas. Okay, I don't want to be fucking looked at like I am a fucking vagina, to where men want to, that's all that they fucking see me as. I am so much more than that. I am over this shit. I am over this fucking shit. I'm back on this weird celibacy kick, because here's the thing. This is what I know, and this is gonna cut me off in a second, and I might have to make a second video. I do not want to have a baby. I do not want to grow a human being inside of my freaking body, okay? I do not want to have to take care of that thing at all. I do not want that responsibility. I have no desire whatsoever to procreate at all. And what happens when boys put their penises inside of girls, sometimes babies are conceived, and I honestly cannot even fathom that. And I will say it again, if you are judging me right now, you need to go look at yourself. Because if I choose to have sex, and right now I am choosing not to have sex, believe me, I can better than anybody do what I need to do. Plus, my sacred sexual energy is my own, and I don't really feel like spilling it all around and sharing it with anybody anymore. Really, honestly. Because here's the thing, if I did get pregnant, I more than likely would have this turmoil battle with inside of myself if I should get an abortion, or if that soul has chosen to enter my body. So the only way that I can know that this doesn't happen for sure is by not having sex. Okay? So that's where I'm at on that. For two, I think I need to do a second video real quick about this, because I need to start there. Also, I don't have the greatest track record with fucking penises anyway. And in fact, my first encounter with fucking penises probably warped me for life. And it is something that I have had to come to terms within me of. And I really feel like I have finally healed myself on that one. Okay, I'm gonna be done with this video, and I'm gonna go on to video number two of what I feel about the fluidity and not fluidity. Okay.